Pampala spokesperson Edwin Lasierda said the government expects the PPCRV to still maintain its functions as an election watchdog with or without the bishops. And we're joined now on the line by PPCRV chairperson, former Ambassador Tita Divilla. Ambassador Divilla, maganda hapo po sa inyo.
Tony?
Yes. Yes.
Tony, hi. Good afternoon. And to all the listeners of your program now.
Oh, good afternoon. Oh, let's get down to the business at hand, and that's the seeming dissatisfaction being expressed by the bishops, even the Lipa Archbishop Ramon Arguelles saying that he distrusts the PPCRV in a sense. So what can you say about that?
Yes, Tony, I will just make first one clarification. Ano? It is the Archbishop of Lipa who expressed his distrust of PPCRV, or what he said in some of his text messages, first anonymous and then signed later on, betrayal of trust. Number one, he did mention mock elections, that we called the mock elections successful. And as I was listening now to what he was telling you, that we said that the glitches were minor. In our mock elections report submitted to COMELEC, we are supposed to submit, because we are a citizen's arm of COMELEC. Accreditation as citizen's arm is in the law. It says that we have to help COMELEC do its job of managing the elections by doing some of the things that we are mandated to do. And one is voters' education, the other one is poll watching, and the third one now, from 2010 to now, is conducting the unofficial parallel count. Going back to the mock elections, there were 20 sites. And what we did was to collect all the reports of our PPCRV volunteers in those 20 sites. I myself covered the one of UP from 6 o'clock in the morning up to 3 o'clock the next morning, because we conducted a random manual audit. But then, in that report, we cited all the glitches that were reported by our volunteers, myself included. And we cited there the constant paper jams and so on, the malfunctioning of the PCOS, the delayed transmissions, the difficulty in transmitting. And we even gave our observations and recommendations to COMELEC. Nowhere in that report did we say it was successful. Nowhere in that report did we term the glitches that happened as minor. What we said in our observations is that it was a good thing that it happened at the mock elections, so that the COMELEC can really focus its attention on seeing to it that these glitches don't happen come May 13, 2013, election time. We did that. And another thing, I also copy-furnished every bishop, every diocese in the Philippines with that report of February 6, 2013. Now, when I said this to Bishop Arguelles, he said he did not deny or confirm whether he got the report. But we did send, and it is through their email. And all the rest of the emails we send to them, it goes through. No, because we are told also there is an error in delivery. Okay, that's one, mock election. The second one is that we are always we ignore or approve COMELEC's undermining election system by not restoring the basic safeguards. I am now mentioning the things that he said, no? Not through you only, but through text messages and interviews with him. I was saying, Tony, that COMELEC is the constitutionally mandated body to manage Philippine elections. Hence, it is COMELEC who chooses the technology, or the AES, including the machine, the PCOS machine. PPCRV, as member of the COMELEC Advisory Council, supported the resolutions of the COMELEC Advisory Council for the enhancements to the PCOS after the 2010 elections, like restore timestamps, restore the UV mark reader, or the improve the auditability logs, the transmission logs, and so on. But we did not join in that move for putting a VVPP to the PCOS machine. What's a VVPP? Voter verified paper trail. That means to say, the voter will get a receipt after voting, will get a receipt of who she or he voted for. Why did we not? Why did we disapprove of that? Because that could be a form for vote buying. No, a receipt. Okay, this is whom I voted for. You can pay me now. If we had a transaction before this, no, regarding vote buying and vote selling. And happily, the COMELEC Advisory Council did not also include this in the list of enhancements. No, and regarding what was the other thing he said? Ah, the fourth copy after voting. Because in his official letter to us of why he is severing ties with the PPCR, the PPCRV, he said that they did not approve of the fact that the Batangas volunteers, PPCRV volunteers, will only act as collectors of the fourth copy of the election return printed by the PCOS after the closing of voting and prior to transmission. This is according to the law, Tony. It is not our edict, directive, or policy. In the Republic Act 9369, which is the Automated Election Act, no, it says there that the PCOS machine at the close of voting prints 8 copies of the election returns, and then before it transmits the results of the elections to the server of the to the canvassing consolidation of the municipality, city, and COMELEC server, and then the KBP server, which is now called Transparency Server. Okay. And the volunteers in that, in all the clustered precincts, get to see all of these printed forms coming out of the PCOS. In fact, the volunteers are made to sign each and every copy of those 8 election returns. The dominant majority political party, the dominant minority political party, and the PPCRV poll watcher, as well as the other accredited citizens arm who are there. They sign all of these copies. You do not sign what you do not see, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So the volunteers really get to see them.
Right.
But if his point is that he himself does not get to see them, well, then there are more than 2,000 clustered precincts in Batangas, Tony. And before, if you will look at each one of them, before that reaches our command center in Manila,
mm-hmm.
canvassing and consolidation would have been over. And another thing, when the BEI puts the fourth copy and all of those other copies, no, of the 8 copies inside the envelope, it is sealed in front of them after they have signed it and seen it. And then it's given to each of the recipients of those 7 copies. The 8th copy is posted at the polling place, no? Mm-hmm. And then when this is given to the PPCRV volunteer, the PPCRV volunteer in turn gives it to our courier, that sealed envelope gives it to our courier to send it to Manila for our unofficial parallel count.
Yeah.
So I do not know. I cannot second guess the law. But I guess the point of sealing it when it is transferred for delivery to the national bodies of these recipients
mm-hmm.
is to avoid any loss or any tampering of the election return. Mm-hmm. That's it.
All right. Now, well, you've answered and clarified the actions that the PPCRB has taken with respect to these issues that have been raised by Archbishop Arguelles, but. Does it seem to you, at least, Ambassador de Villa, that with Archbishop Arguelles and other civic groups having expressed their distrust or even disenchantment with the PPCRV, that this has somehow already put a dent in the credibility of your organization?
No, I cannot. I don't think so, Tony, because with the help of God, thanks to God, with the grace of God, it's only Lipa. It's only the Archdiocese of Lipa that severed their ties. There is one other diocese, even before this thing happened, even after their meeting in January, already had advised me that they will just go into voters' education because they are planning another advocacy for their diocese. So instead of poll watching, mm-hmm. since this is just a small diocese, they would rather concentrate on an advocacy of who to vote for and who not to vote for. And as I said, as usual, we respect the decision of the bishop. So, in turn, we make contingency plans like now for Batangas. We already have sufficient volunteers to cover the retrieval of the fourth copy of the election returns.
Mm-hmm.
But the rest are, business as usual, Tony. It's just now, that's why I can't go there for a guesting.
Yes.
Because we are now packing and deploying our IDs, our mm-hmm. appointment papers, the checklist for the poll watchers, because they have to do some checklist for the testing and sealing,
right.
And also for the initialization report. It's business as usual.
I wonder if you can actually, or if you've already given your reaction to an earlier report about this manifesto that was signed by several civic society groups. And in the manifesto, it said that while the PPCRV was organized as a citizen's arm to promote clean, honest, accurate, and meaningful elections, that its leadership has, and I'm quoting from the manifesto, has subverted its mandate. I wonder if you were aware of that manifesto and if you've ever had a chance to react to it.
I heard of it, but those things, I mean to say, how would you call that, dignifying those reports that are just from a few who are really detractors of the automated election system,
mm-hmm.
Well, I cannot change their mind. It's up to them. But so far, we have been getting, as of now, Tony,
mm-hmm.
I already have listed here with us, I mean for the IDs, 200,000 volunteers. So I guess we also give a space to the people who are not always using media for propaganda, but who are really unproclaimed lives, doing their best, no? To help to serve the country through helping in the elections in a nonpartisan way. And because for most of our volunteers, love for God and love for country are indivisible.
All right. Ambassador Davila, appreciated that you took the time to speak with us today, and thank you very much
I can't see you face to face, but I guess there will come a time when we will be there in the studio again.
All right. Hoping to see you here in the studio soon, Ambassador Davila. Thank you very much.
Thanks. God bless.